And then in April of 1964, IBM announced the biggest announcement in the company, they're betting the company on this, that they could bring out a whole family of computers on a single day that varied in price and performance. As you can see, it had 8-bit computers all the way up to a 64-bit wide data path computer, and the different memory speeds. So if you look on the most expensive and most powerful one had microinstructions that were 87 bits wide, the kind of every bit to the control line. So it was wider because there was a more powerful data path, there was more of the control. Since it's doing basically an instruction interpreter in microcode, you didn't need as many lines if it was really wide. And people back then called that horizontal microprogramming. And on the left, with the simpler data paths, it's only 50-bit wide instructions because there wasn't as much control, but it took more steps, so the microprograms are longer. It was 4K of these, and so they call that vertical microprogramming. But it's microprogramming. That's kind of a read-only based way of doing control. So IBM bet the company, and it won the bet. So in today's dollars, it was $1.5 million for an 8-bit computer, and $9 million for a 64-bit computer, and they dominated mainframes. And to this day, there are descendants in the mainframe market from this architecture that still dominate mainframes. So IBM won that bet. And then the person who made this happen, a key person who made this happen, is Fred Brooks Jr. He was one of the architects who made the bet and came up with that design. And he's a second winner of the Turing Award.